class, today's lesson is on the National Women's Party and women's suffrage. Suffrage is a word that means the right to vote. So suffrage means being able to go to the polls on election day and cast your ballot for your candidates that won in office. Women did not have the right to vote earlier on. The women's suffrage movement, the suffragists, had two ways to obtain this right, two paths, two goals. And one was a state-by-state strategy, where they would make it legal for women to vote in each state, state by state, starting with Wyoming in 1869. And the other strategy was to get a constitutional amendment passed. And to do that, they had to have suffragists in Washington, D.C. lobbying Congress. Okay. NAWSA, N-A-W-S-A, that's the National American Women's Suffrage Association. They were the lead organization in the suffrage movement. The president of NAWSA was Carrie Chapman Catt. That's her picture at the top left-hand corner. She was president of NAWSA from 1900 to 1904. Again in 1915. By this time, there was a new generation of suffragists coming up and joining NAWSA. Many of these younger suffragists had been to England to help with the suffrage movement there, and they brought back the tactics that they were using in England, including civil disobedience and nonviolent protest. And they brought these ideas back to the United States with them. This is a new generation. And their leader, as it turned out, became Alice Paul. This is her picture on the right, in the middle. Alice Paul. Inez Hayes, Mulholland, in Washington, D.C. She was part of that element. The younger suffragists asked NAWSA if they could reopen the women's suffrage office in Washington, D.C. to start lobbying again. And NAWSA gave them permission, and they started to work on the amendment once again. At around this time. And so now they have combined strategies. They have a state-by-state strategy, and they have a national strategy to get an amendment to the Constitution passed. Okay. This national element at Washington, D.C., they had other ideas on how to get this done. And they're going to use those ideas. Civil disobedience, nonviolent protest, starting with a suffrage parade. They're going to have a women's suffrage parade. They're going to schedule it for the same day that President-elect Woodrow Wilson has his parade, his inauguration parade, when he comes to Washington. Consequently, most of the people who would have gone to his inauguration parade went to the suffrage parade instead. Okay. And the suffrage parade was led by Inez Hayes Mulholland. This is a picture from that parade. She was at the front of the parade riding on a white horse. There will be a parting of ways. There will be a split in the movement between the older generations of suffragists and this younger generation. And they will have the same goal in mind, split over the controversy of the new considered radical tactics, including picketing the White House. This is the first organization ever to picket the White House, to protest in front of the White House, the women's suffrage movement. It'll be the first of many movements that do that as a tactic. Okay, Woodrow Wilson, he was a Democrat. He was against women's suffrage. He will be one of the last ones to get on board. Now, many of the men and some women who were against women's suffrage before, once these headlines come from Washington, D.C. about all of these radical tactics, what that will do to many conservative Americans, it will turn them against the tactics, but they will be able to support the traditional suffragists who are still lobbying politely, writing letters to Congress members and legislators. And so they're going to be able to support the more conservative suffragists because of the radical, so-called radical suffragists in Washington, D.C. And so this will turn the tide. This will create a critical mass of American population to support this. Finally, Woodrow Wilson gives a speech in Congress near the end of World War I saying that we should give the women the right to vote. If you want to know more about this, you should watch this movie directed by Katja von Gagnon. It's called Iron Jawed Angels. There are some embellishments in it, including a love interest. However, the history behind it is very sound. The background history is what happened. Any questions? Okay, cut.